experiment is about Faraday's law. We have a galvanometer set to measure electric current. The zero of the galvanometer is in the middle of its screen. The galvanometer is connected across the terminals of a copper coil. This closed circuit does not include a source of electromotive force. In a previous episode, we explained the electromagnetic induction phenomenon. We move the magnet beside the coil. The needle is deflected in two opposite directions. What was the explanation of this? During the motion of the magnet, the coil is crossed by a variable magnetic flux, so it becomes the seat of induced electromotive force. So the circuit carries an electric current because it is closed. But in this experiment, I want to focus on the relation between the speed of the magnet and the electromotive force. So observe. Now I will move the magnet slowly towards and away from the coil, and then quickly. Again, I move the magnet slowly towards and away from the coil, and then quickly. So we observe that when we move the magnet slowly, the deflection of the needle is small, while when we move the magnet quickly or fast, the deflection of the needle increases. When the deflection of the needle increases, this means that a larger induced current is carried by the circuit. A larger induced current is due to a larger induced electromotive force. But how can we relate this to the variation in the magnetic flux? Now, when we move the magnet faster, then the variation in the magnetic flux increases. So when the variation in the magnetic flux increases, we have a larger induced current, so a larger induced electromotive force. And the question now is, how can we relate the induced electromotive force to the variation in the magnetic flux? Let's move to Faraday's law.